Hey guys, and welcome to the Get a Brew channel. Today we are going to be talking about triclamps. So stick around, we're going to go through everything you need to know about using these awesome little fittings. So, what is a triclamp? Triclamps are basically fittings that are used to connect pipes together. For instance, here's a 2-inch triclamp, and if you're wanting to connect another fitting over to this, you're using this. So triclamps, also known as triclovers, which is basically a brand name, they're exactly the same thing. So we're gonna be referring to these as triclamps. So triclamps are often used in the food and beverage industry, pharmaceutical industries, and biotechnology industries. So the reason why they use triclamp fittings in those industries is because they need everything tight, secure, and kept sanitary. And that's a great thing about triclamp fittings is because of the way they work, there's no moving parts and you can get a good seal. So let's get into the parts that go into a triclamp. Basically, you have what they call the ferrule, this large bit over here. You can see it's slightly beveled. Then you got the clamp itself. The clamp has also got two little beveled sections. So when you're actually fitting in something in there, it's got a nice tight secure that's gonna actually squash these together. The next part is the little rubber O-ring. This needs to fit quite nicely and securely into this little groove. You can see that groove that goes around the outside of that ferrule. That fits straight into there. You'll have your other part, whatever it is, also fitting nice and securely. And that just all goes together. And that's it. There's your triclamp fitting all put together. So what are the benefits of using triclamp fittings in your brewing days? Quite simple. You get a fast, very secure connection. It ain't going nowhere. Once you've got your parts together, it's stuck. It's also very quick and easy to assemble. You're not using any major tools. You're not using anything special to put these together. And it's literally just marrying two pieces together, tightening up. Another thing is the versatility. You can get plenty of fittings that are gonna fit onto your different triclamps. You can get reducers that are gonna go from a 2-inch to a 1-inch, for instance, and a range of other different products. For instance, here's a nice gate valve. Put those two together, sorted, and you can fit other fittings straight onto this, not a problem. Also, the way it's been designed, it's leak resistant. With this little rubber O-ring that you have over here, once that's actually secured in place and you've got everything tightly done up, you're not gonna get any leaks. Let's now talk about putting your triclamps together using fittings or whatever else that you wanna use on your brew day. Again, you've basically got three parts that you need to take care of. It's gonna be your flange fittings, your O-ring, or gasket, whatever you want to call it, and of course your clamp. Make sure everything is nice and clear, nice and clean. You don't have any bits or pieces inside that groove over there. You basically take your gasket, put it on there, make sure that's seated nicely in that groove. You take your other part. In this case, I'm just using a little cover just to show you exactly how this works. Make sure those two are fitting nice and securely together. You take your triclamp, fit it around, make sure that that's all together. And all you do, tighten up your nut over there. What you're wanting to try and avoid is tightening it too tight. If you tighten it too tight, the rubber gasket that you got inside you is gonna flare out, and you're probably not gonna get a good seal, and also that can introduce little microorganisms fitting underneath the gasket. So hand tightening will work wonderfully for a triclamp fitting. If you are finding it difficult, if you have dexterity issues, you can put maybe a little screwdriver inside there, but again, do not over-torque it. You will have issues. That'll also cause issues when trying to take it off if you start squashing the metals together. So again, hand tightening works perfectly fine. Taking it apart is exactly the same. undo the nut, and literally that all comes apart. Easy. So you've got your triclamps. Now you want to know what size triclamps to get. Well, firstly, inside the actual triclamp itself, you'll see it'll be written here. For instance, this is a 2-inch. Here we've got a 1.5-inch. Those are pretty much the common sizes that you're going to be using. It's the 1.5-inch, and sometimes you will get a 2-inch fitting, but 1.5-inch is the usual one that you'll have. The way to know what size triclamp to get is you measure the outside diameter of the pipe, not the actual ferrule size. That'll determine what size triclamp you need. For instance, this is a 2-inch pipe, and you'll know you need a 2-inch triclamp fitting on there. And again, obviously your 1.5-inch is not going to fit inside there. As you can see there, it's not going to give you a good seal. Now, if you do have a fitting that you're not too sure on the actual size of the triclamp that you need there, for instance, this little valve over here, you're not going to see an outside diameter because that is a lot smaller than a typical pipe would be. You can measure the flange, and there are conversion charts to let you know what triclamp size it is. We'll put it down in the links below, or check out our blog article on triclamps. That'll give you a good indication on what sizes to use. Now that we know pretty much everything we need to know about triclamps, what can you do with them? Well, for instance, we've got the Conicus Pro over here. We're using this as our test model. If you want to check those out, you want to check out the video all about the Conicus Pro, check out the link over here. You want to, for instance, put one of these valves on the front here. This is used for dumping trub at the bottom. You can see there's one really actually on there. Simply make sure that your size is all correct. You're going to put a valve on. We've also got different fittings. For instance, here is a ball lock gas post. You can put that on there, gas up your equipment. There's also liquid, so if you want liquid out, gas in. Something like this with the threaded male on the top here, you can easily adapt that to other fittings that you need. Sight glasses, this is a great way for you to be able to see what's going in and out of your fermenters. Those are basically a few of the fittings that you can actually use using triclamps onto your brewing equipment. You can check down the links below. We'll put a link to our triclamp section. You can have a good look at all of that. So yeah, guys, thanks for joining us. That's everything you need to know about triclamps. If you want to know more, check it out on our blog article. We'll put the link in the description. That's it. Have a great day and happy brewing.